وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ The masjid belongs to Allah. The masjid doesn't belong to any king or any ruler or any khalifa or any trust body. The masjid belongs to Allah. It is His rules. It is His system that will apply in the masjid. Hadith Qudsi, Allah says, بُيُوتِي فِي الْأَرْضِ الْمَسَاجِدِ The word buyut, which is the plural of bayt, houses. Allah says, my houses on the earth. Buyuti fil ardil masajid. Buyuti fil ardil masajid. My houses on this earth are the masjid. Ummaruha zuwaruha. Ummaruha zuwaruha. Those whose lives will revolve around the masjid. Those who will give their lives but never abandon the masjid. Those who are what we call Ummarul Masajid. Who are the Ummarul Masajid? Allah says in the Quran, Innama Ya'muru Masajid Allah, Man Amana Billah, Wal Yawmil Akhir, Wa Aqama As-Salah, Wa Ata As-Zakah, Wa Lam Yakhsha Illa Allah. Allahu Akbar, what a statement Quran makes. Allah is speaking of Amirul Masajid, those who will keep the masjid alive. Those who are going to make abadi of masjid, who are they? Quran says, they have Iman on Allah. They have Iman on Akhirat. They will establish Salah. They will discharge their Zakah. And they will fear no one but Allah. وَلَمْ يَخْشَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ The people that keep the masjid abad will fear no system. Will fear no propaganda. Will fear no lies. Will fear no treachery. Will not fall into the deceptions and plots of the enemies of Islam. وَلَمْ يَخْشَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ They will fear no one but Allah. They will first put Allah's system in front and then every other system. فَعَسَىٰ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنْ يَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُهْتَدِينَ Allah says, these are the people on Hidayat. These are the people on Hidayat. Who? عُمَّارُ الْمَسَاجِدِ عُمَّارُ الْمَسَاجِدِ Allah Ta'ala, Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Inna ummara baytillah hum ahlullah. Those who keep the masjid abad, those whose lives revolve around the masjid, those who will never give up the masjid. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, these are the family people of Allah. These are the household of Allah. Man alif al masjid alifahullah. The one who loves the masjid, Allah loves him. The one who loves the masjid, Allah loves him. The one who loves the masjid, Allah loves him. We want Allah's love. We want Allah's acceptance. إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُ الَّذِينَ يَعْتَادُ الْمَسْجِدِ فَشَهَدُوا لَهُ بِالْإِيمَانِ My Nabi said, if you see someone whose life revolves around the masjid, then Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, give shahadat, bear testimony, he has Iman. He has Iman. Coming back to that hadith, Hadith Qudsi, Allah says, بُيُوتِي فِي الْأَرْضِ الْمَسَاجِدِ My houses on the earth are the masjids. أُمَّارُهَا زُوَّارُهَا Those who will make the masjid abad, they are the guests. They are the guests. They are the guests. Who is the host? They are the guests. Who is the host? تُوبَى تُوبَى لِمَن تَطَخَّرَ فِي بَيْتِهِ ثُمَّ زَارَنِي Allahu Akbar, Hadith Qudsi. Rasulullah says, Allah says, Mubarak. Mubarak, congratulations. Shabash to who? To the one who makes wudu at home. And then what should it have been, literally? Thumma atal masjid, dhahba ila al masjid, dakhal al masjid, jaa ila al masjid. That's what it should have been. Then he made his wudu, then he left his house, went to the masjid, walked to the masjid, approached the masjid, entered the masjid. Yet Allah doesn't say that. What does Allah say? Mubarak to the one who made wudu at home. Thumma zarani. Then he came to visit me, visit Allah. Then he came to visit me. And then what does Allah say? Fahakkun ala al mazuri an yukrima zairahu. Allah says, when he does this, he has a haqq upon me. Because now he is my guest and I am his host. Now he is my guest, Allah's guest, and Allah is your host. When you will make the masjid abad, inna lil masjidi awtada, inna lil masjidi awtada. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there are some people, this word that's found in the hadith, awtada is the plural of watad. Watad means a peg. Why this analogy? Because once you drill a peg into the ground, knock it into the ground, it doesn't move. You can't shake it. You'll have to use great physical force to pull it out. This analogy. They are stuck to the masjid. You will never find them away from the masjid unnecessarily. They are the people of the masjid. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, in my ummah, there will be some people like that. Otad will be the pegs of the masjid. What is their maqam? What is their status? Again, unfortunately, we don't have that munasabat with Arabic. What it should have been in the hadith? Hum julasa'ul malaika. That's what it should have been. Hum julasa'ul malaika. They are in the company of the angels. Yet Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't say that. He said, Al-Malaikatu julasa'uhum. Al-Malaikatu julasa'uhum. Understand this by an analogy. Sometimes you hear some great Allah-wala, pious Shaykh, Alim, Mufti, Muttaqi has come to town. So what do we do? Quickly, we get together. You know what? Let's go and sit in the company of that Shaykh, in the company of that Allah-wala. Let's go and sit in his company because we will benefit. Inna lil masjid awtada al malaikatu julasa'um. This is what it means. The malaika of Allah say, let us go and sit in the company of that person. The malaika say, let us go and sit in the company of that person. Al malaikatu julasa'um. In ghabu iftaqaduhum. If he is missing from the masjid, they go looking for him. In maridu aduhum. If he becomes sick, they go and visit him. In kanu fi hajatin anuhum. If there is any work that out of necessity has kept him away from the masjid, Rasulullah says, these people of my ummah are such, their maqam is such, that the malaika of Allah go and assist them to finish their work quickly so that they can come back to the masjid.